Hey everyone. So I was recently asked in the comments of one of my videos if I knew of anyone that made a suppressor for the Airforce Texan. Well, at the time I didn't, but I shortly after found out about a company that does offer a suppressor, or a shroud. The company is RL Airgun Supply. They are out of Pueblo, Colorado. And I bought one. So, it's technically called a shroud, not a suppressor, though I have seen the internals. It is functionally a suppressor, but shroud gets around a lot of legal issues, as it is legal to suppress an air rifle, it is not necessarily legal to suppress a firearm, and a shroud has to only ever work on the air rifle. So it's a bit of a gray area, but a company figured out a legal way to do it, and today I'm going to install it. I will test it in another video coming up shortly, as soon as it warms up. It's quite cold out right now. So before we get started, let's take a look on the inside of this and see what it's made of. So this item has a list price from RL Airgun Supply of $165, not including taxes and shipping and handling. What you see here is exactly how it comes out of the packaging, but it's a little more complicated than this. If we open it up, it opens at the back end. We have a new end cap, which will replace the one on the gun. We have a new barrel bushing. That is this component here. And we have an extender sleeve here. They are two separate components. Now, inside the barrel itself, we have what's called the alignment cup. It essentially keeps the end of the barrel perfectly aligned with the suppressor tube. And we have four K-style baffles. So functionally, this is in fact a suppressor, not just a bloop tube. However, certain functionality of it does work like a bloop tube. Okay, now that we know what's inside of the Texan Shroud, let's start talking about how to install it. The first step in the instructions is they want you to remove the spin lock tank and make sure it's cleared. Well, I know it's cleared. I've checked it before. I believe removing the spin lock tank is a safety feature, but I'm not certain. So either way, it'll fit better on the desk if the tank is removed. So let's start there. Okay. So the tank's been removed from the body of the rifle. You can decock these by slightly drawing back on the lever, putting the safety off, pulling the trigger, and then lowering the lever back down. Now the next step in this is to remove the barrel. Unfortunately, because I have this bipod on here, I have an additional step in between. I need to remove my bipod mount from up here. Alright, that just slides off the front, held on by six Allen screws. Okay, so the next step is removing the barrel. I also need to remove the barrel end cap. Now to do this, there's one single Allen screw on the underside of the rifle, near the front, which is the reason I had to remove my Picatinny rail. So let's start with that one. Okay, so fully removing all of these Allen screws and setting them aside, we will use them again later. The barrel nut, or I'm sorry, the end cap will pop right out, like so. Now, to remove the barrel itself, there are eight set screws, four on the left side of the rifle and four on the underside of the rifle. I am going to fully remove these. And the four underneath. Now, at this point, the barrel should be fairly easy to remove from the rifle. It comes right out. Just like that. So far, I must note, this is a very easy rifle to work on. This has all been pretty much effortless. Now, what we're going to do from here is we're going to remove the factory barrel bushing, which is this little part here, and we are going to put on the new barrel bushing, which is this part. Now, it's going to go in the exact same spot as the previous one. It is only held on by one Allen screw, but you can see the Allen marks from the barrel hold inside all of the holes. We're going to use those to line the barrel bushing back up. All right, that came right out. Pull this Allen screw out and save that because we're going to use that in reassembling it. It's that one there, which is very small. Now this should try not to scratch my barrel. It's a little stiff. There we go. And it comes right off. There is the factory one. Now the threads go forward because that's for attaching the extension. This will slide right back on. Butt it right up against the little stop here that's built into the barrel. Line up all of our barrel, or all of our screw marks on the barrel. Ensure they're in exactly the right spot because we need them back. I snugged it up and now I'm checking to make sure they're all in exactly the right spot. Kind of wants to go back together in the way it came apart, so that makes it easy. And I'm going to snug this up. Not too tight, but nice and snug. Okay, at this point, we need to install the extension tube. Now, the extension tube meets up with those threads, as you saw me take it apart earlier. That's going to slide on here and screw onto those threads like so. And I don't want to get it overly tight, but nice and snug. And from there, this should be ready to go back in the gun. So, this end up, barrel slides carefully back in, trying to scratch it on as few things as possible in the process, because I'm obsessive like that. And right there, all of the holes continue to line up, and we're going to put all of these set screws back in. Okay, now that our barrel is back in, we want to look down the Allen set screw holes to make sure that we can see the scratch marks in the side of the barrel where the Allen screws hold it in. Now, when we took apart the barrel, we had a total of 9 Allen set screws. Now, there are 5 shorter ones and there are 4 longer ones. Now, the shorter ones are intended for use in the side of the Texan, while as the longer ones are underneath, with the exception of one other short one, which is for the barrel end cap. So I'm going to just put these in their holes, bottom them out, but not tighten them all the way yet. We want to make sure all of the pieces line up before we tighten anything down. Take our 4 longer ones here. Alright, I had a little trouble getting these front ones back in on the nut that I replaced, so I'm lightening the screws up here. And what do you know, they went in perfectly. Why we don't tighten anything until we're ready to snug everything up. Having a little difficulty with this one. There it goes. Alright, they're all in. I'm going to start snugging them up. Alright, while I'm tightening these, I am tightening them, but it's not how tight can I possibly get them. You don't want to over tighten anything and strip anything. These aren't that big of screws. So just kind of nice and firm, but no pliers or anything like that. Just tight, like that. There we go. Alright, so our barrel is back in. Next step is to install the new barrel end cap. So we're going to slide this on here very carefully, because I don't want to scratch my barrel if I can help it. And very carefully, we want to seat it in the threads. And I can't feel it, but there's a nice trick to making sure you don't cross-thread something. What you can do is actually turn it, they're all right-handed threads, so you want to turn it left very slowly until you hear it click. There, right there. So once you hear it click, it'll drop and it will align nicely with the other threads. And now it's going on nicely. So we're going to tighten this up. Now, if factory is to be believed, it should align perfectly. I need to back up a step and actually install my Picatinny rail, because once I install this, it will be more difficult to reinstall. So unscrewing this for a second, I'm going to slide my Picatinny rail back on, this time in such a way that I can still see that Allen screw. Lesson learned. So again, I'm just going to snug all these up, get it kind of started on this rail. Sure it's seated correctly. All right, so now same process as before. We slide our barrel nut in, turn left until we feel it click. Right there. And now it goes on nicely. Now we tighten this all the way up. It should flush mount to the front of the main body of the rifle. Pretty close. There's about a 32nd of an inch in there, but nothing to worry about. It's nice and firm. And once that's in there, we can reinstall our end cap set screw. Now, the instructions actually say do not reinstall this set screw, but looking at it, I see no reason we can't reinstall it. It should work just as well. I'm not going to tighten it real tight though, just in case. Just a little bit. And that should ensure that this doesn't come off if ever I need to open up the suppressor. Say for sound testing in the next video with the Texan. Alright, so I am going to snug up all of these screws one more time, make sure they're nice and tight. Those are nice and tight. Now, lastly, we need to install our barrel end cap, which keeps it all aligned. We want to make sure that it is all the way seated, which is pretty easy to do. Set that down gently. And install our baffles. Now, when installing the baffles, the way these work is when you have two of them together, the flat kind of stops the progression of the pressure wave, and the air expands out into this conical section on the outside. So what you want to make sure you do is you want to make sure these expand flat side or wide open side forward. Now, this is the muzzle, screws on back here. So the open side goes in first, just like that. There are four of them. We install all four, let them drop to the end. And we're going to very carefully install this on the rifle, and we should be done. All right. Okay, so same trick as before. Make sure we're finding the right spot. Right there. Click nice and loud that time. And slowly tighten it on. Again, I don't want to over-tighten it, but nice hand snug fit. And there we go. We now have a suppressed Texan. If you're English, a moderated Texan. So I'm going to throw the spin lock tank back on real quick. I'm not going to film it. Hopefully you know how to do that. And then we'll call it good. And there we have it. According to the manufacturer, it adds approximately 8 inches to the end of your Texan barrel, which pretty much means it will fit in no case you can find for it. But it does unscrew, so I suppose you could unscrew the suppressor each time and fit it into a case. Overall, that installation was extremely easy. I actually thought it was going to be more difficult than that, but still difficult enough that I wouldn't want to do it in the field. So, next video with the Texan, I'm going to both fire the Texan with and without the shroud and measure the sound, so stay tuned for that. And after that, we will be measuring with the bullet adjuster. So we will be building on the data I built in my previous video with the Texan to figure out how to fine-tune it for the 166 grain bullets. So, hope you found this helpful, hope you enjoyed it. Thanks for watching, and hopefully I'll see you next time.